Hi, I'm Michael Correa, and this is Psych Exam Review. In this video, we're going to go into a little more detail on the biology of memory, and this time we're going to look at the level of neurons. So we're going to look at something known as long-term potentiation, or LTP. Now, long-term potentiation is often summarized with the expression, neurons that fire together, wire together. Now, of course, the neurons don't actually wire together. They maintain their separation at the synapse, right, this gap between the neurons. But what this means is that neurons change their connection to one another, and they strengthen it through chemical signaling. So this refers to strengthened connection between neurons. And since, again, they're not physically connected, this connection occurs in the form of chemical signaling. So how does this work? Well, imagine we have two neurons that are firing together repeatedly. Right? So the first neuron fires, and this causes the second neuron to fire. Well, by repeating this process over and over again, the interaction at the synapse changes. So the first neuron can change the level of neurotransmitter that it's releasing. And the second neuron can actually change its receptors to make it more sensitive to that neurotransmitter. And so what happens is this makes it more likely that when the first neuron fires, the second neuron will also fire. So this is how we have this strengthened connection. So how does this process actually occur? Well, it's not fully understood, but one thing that plays a role is a receptor. This is a receptor for something called N-methyl-D-aspartate. All right, so this is a receptor, and it's a receptor for the neurotransmitter glutamate. Okay, so how do we know that this N-methyl-D-aspartate, or NMDA, plays a role in long-term potentiation and memory formation? Well, some of this research comes from a researcher named Richard Morris. And what Morris did was he created this water maze task, where he would take a mouse and put it in a tank of water that the mouse couldn't see through the water, it was kind of murky, and there would be a hidden platform somewhere in the tank. And so the mouse would have to swim around searching for this platform to stand on so that it could rest. And the idea was that over time, the mouse would get better at finding this platform, right? It's essentially like performing a maze. And the mouse would learn where that platform is and swim directly to it when placed into the tank. Now, this allowed for comparison between mice. So some of these mice were given a drug that blocks the activity of this NMDA receptor. And as a result of this, their ability to learn where the platform was impaired. And this shows that this NMDA may play a role in the formation of memory and learning. Okay, so that's the basic idea of long-term potentiation and the role of NMDA in this process. I hope you found this helpful. If so, please like the video and subscribe to the channel for more. Thanks for watching.